Defender is something special. It's this unbelievable capability, it's this engineering excellence. It's an icon all around the world.
Don't drop it.
We use Land Rovers as training vehicles in the military. We've all used them in some sort of capacity.
The bottom line is it's clearly a versatile, robust bit of kit.
Jaguar Land Rover's involvement was absolutely key to the success of the games.
So I learned to drive in a Land Rover when I was a little kid. Just used to be able to sort of almost half sit on the seat and I could just reach the pedals and sort of half stand up and look out.
Hello, Jim, mate, how you doing? It should have been a no-brainer for anybody to invest in the original Defender line. It's going to go anywhere, whether it's a desert, whether it's a swamp, whether it's a mountainous road. So for me, I definitely would have said I'm in.
I mean, basically, this is just one big Meccano kit, isn't it?
I've had some great fun in these. Ah.
I've actually worked here on the assembly line when I was a young engineer. It's in my blood, I've grown up with it. I was even born in Load Lane, which is the address of the company.
I drove one of the very first Defenders on this attempt to be the first people to drive from the English Channel to Singapore. You know, I spent some of the happiest days of my life in the Defender. When I'm buried, I don't want a hearse. I want to go in the back of a Land Rover.
You know, when you work for the Red Cross, you get the sense that you're the only ones who can travel that path. You are reaching the most vulnerable, the most remote communities.
The amazing thing about the Defender, it's not about the vehicle really, it's about the people we can help as a result of actually being able to access those places.
This particular vehicle is special to me as an auctioneer, but also as a Land Rover enthusiast, because it's the 2-millionth, and a unique vehicle with such incredible history is very desirable.
Well, I mean, having done an apprenticeship in this factory as a young kid, it brings back a lot of memories.
Every summer, we would drive up to Anglesey, driving over rough ground, then over the sand dunes, down to the beach, and it was always an exciting event.
It's maybe you do, yeah.
Two-millionth Defender, an incredible vehicle that saved my backside more times than I can ever say. From deserts, jungles, mountains, you name it, this guy has been a friend.
I have always been a Defender man, right from my days in the Marines. If there's one vehicle I want to be sitting in when things start going wrong, the Defender is my magic carpet.
Well, I was born and grew up in the Lake District, and the Defender was just the vehicle of choice for farmers, for the mountain rescue teams, for climbers. You know, I knew all about this vehicle long before I even thought about joining the motor industry.
My mum and dad drove the Land Rover when they made the film, Born Free, in the 1960s. I drove Land Rovers across the Sahara in the 70s, and then Born Free came along, and what have we been doing ever since, driving Land Rovers? So, you know, it's a long, long relationship between the charity and this amazing, iconic vehicle.
So I feel like I'm connected with Land Rover in a way that very few people are. It's in my heart.
The Defender, I think in a way, is the defender of wildlife. When my husband Bill and I were making the film Born Free with the lions, yeah, we used to pop them in the back of the Land Rover, drive out on the plains, and then sometimes, of course, they rode on top of the Land Rover, which they absolutely adored. The whole Land Rover Defender story has been part of our family too. The memories are very strong.
You know, I think you develop bonds with things that you depend on. Back home, we own an old 1974 Defender, and I'll load up the back with a picnic and the family, and we'll go off. So for me, it's as much about that as it is, you know, the world's extremes.
How you doing, Monty?
Here we go.
The guns job.
I've got the guns.
I love it.